It tells us how the force is acting, how the force is being applied, how it is acting, okay? Action and reaction we have discussed, okay? So few examples we already discussed, pushing a wall, motion of a boat, moving away from the shore, okay? Next is motion of boat in water, how the boat is moving in water, okay? So mainly this is the water, and here, for example, we have the boat, and a person again sitting inside, okay? And oars are there, okay? So what happens here? The man or the woman, whatever the person, pushes the water backward. So this oar is, this is the force applied on the water. We are pushing the water backward. We are pushing the water backward. This is the way oar applies force on the water. Now, in turn, the water we apply.
Good morning,
force.
Sir.
Good morning. Okay. Very good morning to all, and good afternoon as well. Okay. So now this man pushes the water with oars. The person pushes the water with oars. It's okay now. Good afternoon. Okay. Now we are pushing the water with oars. As the person pushes the water with oars, what happens? The water will push forward. This is the force applied. There will be reaction force, and this boat will be pushed in forward direction. This is the action, and this is the reaction. Okay, this is the action and reaction. So, oar pushes the water backward. One more time, we say good afternoon. I will block you from the class. Okay. So, initial 30 seconds are fine for good afternoon. After that, don't say. Just go join the class silently. So this is the action and this is the reaction. That's how the boat moves forward. This example is clear?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Next, we take off a gun. Next, we are going to take a gun. Okay. Okay. You all have seen a gun. Okay. For example, this is the gun trigger. Okay. Now see here, as bullet is fired, how the bullet is fired? The gun applies force on the bullet. The gun applies force on the bullet. So this is the force of action. This is the action. The force applied by the gun on the bullet is the action force. Now in return, this bullet will apply force on the gun, and that will be the reaction force. So that's why whenever you fire a bullet, you feel a force backward, a recoil, the gun recoils. So whenever you fire a bullet, the bullet moves forward, it applies force on you as well, on the gun, and you feel a force backward. That's gun recoils. So action force, and this is the reaction force. They are equal in magnitude, but opposite in direction. This is clear? Next, we discuss rocket motion.
Yes, sir.
So while discussing rocket motion, it will be clear what is happening inside the gun as well, okay? Like in the gun, the bullet, we have the gunpowder. It burns, it creates pressure there that pushes the bullet in forward direction. Indirectly, we can say the gun is pushing the bullet forward direction. In return, the bullet is pushing the gun in backward direction, okay? So how the rocket? In rocket, we have the gases. Stored. Here we have the fuel. Fuel is stored, and there is a nozzle at the bottom. Okay. Through this gas, through this nozzle, this fuel accepts while combustion takes place. So see what is happening here. When the combustion of the fuel takes place, high temperature and pressure is building inside. Here high temperature and high pressure builds. Because of that high pressure, it tries to expand. The gases start to expand. But the rocket doesn't allow. So what the rocket is making? Rocket is making these gases to escape through the nozzle. Or indirectly we say the rocket is pushing the gases to escape. It is forcing the gases to escape through the nozzle. So we can say the rocket is applying force on the gases. So this is the action force. The rocket applies force on the gases to escape. So gases are escaping in this direction. So this is the direction of the force applied. This is clear. Now, what these gases will do? They will apply equal and opposite force on the rocket. That will be the reaction force. That's how the rocket flies away. Or we can say rocket moves in the forward direction. Understood?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Next one. Motion of a man on the ground. So again, we discuss the motion of a man on the ground. So ground we have. Take one shoe only. Okay. Now see here, what happens? On the ground, we push the ground backward. So this will be our action. This is the action. We are pushing the ground backward. In return, there will be reaction force in this direction. This will be the reaction, equal and opposite to the action. Okay. Now for walking. If we resolve the components, if we resolve this reaction force into two components, that is one parallel to the ground, other vertical, that is perpendicular, normal to the ground. So its component will be this reaction force component, one in this direction, other in this direction. So this horizontal component, it helps us to walk. That is, there is a reaction force in the horizontal direction. It pushes us to move forward. Reaction force we are taking from the ground. Ground is applying reaction force on the foot, and the horizontal component, if we take, that helps us to move forward. This is clear?
Yes, sir.
So we can resolve any force into two components, that is horizontal as well as vertical. Yes, you can ask.
Sir, if we apply the force, if we push the ground forward, then we will move backwards.
Yes, try push. I am moving backward. Yes or no? This time we are pushing the ground forward. Try it, just to try to push the ground forward. As well, this assessment, if you do in sand, you will get to know that sand will be pushed forward. If you move backwards. In sand, you can experience it more precisely. If you move forward, you will see sand will be moving forward, backward. If you are moving backward, you will see sand like this. Yes or no? Here, whatever sand, it was moved for backward. That was because of the action force you applied. Okay. Is this clear? Next, again, we come to the boat. Again, for example, here is the shore and here is the pole on the shore. Okay. Here we have the boat. Okay. So while you are stepping out of the boat on the shore, what happens? While you step out of the boat, here is your shoe or leg, you can say. While stepping out, what you do? You push the boat backward, yes or no? You are pushing the boat backward. In return, the boat pushes you forward. This happens. You push the boat backward. In turn, the boat pushes you forward. Okay. So that's how you step out. Usually what you are seeing, as you push the boat backward, you see the boat moves backward. And sometimes you have seen in funny videos that while pushing back, the man or the woman falls in the water. The boat goes back and falls.
Yes,
you have
sir.
Seen it many
yes.
times. So this is happening. While stepping out of the boat, we are pushing the boat backward. The board of the boat, we are pushing it backward. This is our action force. In return, the boat applies equal and opposite force on us and makes us to move forward. Make us to step out of the boat. So by this action force, the boat moves backward. And sometimes you may fall in the water. So to avoid this, what the boatman do? As he arrives, as the person, he or she arrives, it is tied with the pole. So that when you step out, the boat does not move backward. It will be tightened. There will be, okay. And you can step out. Is this clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Yes. Last one is catching the ball. How you catch the ball? You're catching the ball. What happens? The ball strikes your hand and you stop. So ball is applying action on your hand. That is the action. You feel the pain and you feel the force applied by the ball. That is the action. And you apply the equal and opposite force to the ball. That's how it stops. That's how it stops. Ball force direction, this one. You apply force direction with direction, opposite direction. Equal and opposite force. Action, reaction. As it applies, there will be reaction from the palm, hand, and the ball stops. Have you understood?
Sir?
Yes, sir.
Yes?
Sir, can you again explain, sir, that example of firing a bullet from a gun?
Firing a bullet from a gun, okay. In detail, let's discuss, okay. It's like something like this it is, okay. Bullet. So mainly, for example, it is inside. This is the bullet. It contains gunpowder. Mainly at the back of there is the gunpowder. And as it strikes, it compresses it. It burns. As it burns, what happens? Huge pressure develops here. Huge pressure develops here. Now, these gases want to escape. The gun do not let it to escape this side. But what about this side? It moves forward. It moves forward. Or we can say the gun is pushing the bullet in forward direction. The gun is doing action on the bullet. And this is the action force. And that's how bullet moves forward. Okay. But what about the reaction force? In return, the bullet pushes the gun backward. That will be the reaction force. So you have seen whenever you fire, the gun recoils back. You feel a force backward. You feel a force backward. That is nothing but reaction force. The bullet moves forward. Why? The gun pushes the bullet in forward direction. In return, the bullet pushes the gun backward. That is the gun recoils. So action force, reaction force. Action force on the bullet. Reaction force is on the gun. Understood?
Yes.
Yes. Okay. Sir.
Now let's do the question 10th one, page number 70. Open page number 70. 10th question. A cricket ball of mass 150 gram moving at a speed of 25 meters per second is brought to rest by a player in 0.03 seconds. Find the acceleration. We have to calculate the force which is required to stop the ball. So first calculate the acceleration. We all have calculated, I think. How much force you have got? How much acceleration you have got in the ball? Okay, cricket ball 150 gram. So it will be how much kg? 0.15 kg. So mass is 0.15 kg. U is 25 meter per second. Final velocity is 0. Time taken is 0.
Minus 25 upon 0.03.
Minus 25 upon 0.03, or we can say minus 2500 upon 3 meter per second square. This is the acceleration?
Yes.
Okay. Okay. So see here, what is happening with the ball? Ball is coming and we are catching. So its velocity is decreasing. This negative sign denotes that ball is retarding. The velocity is decreasing. That this negative sign denotes this one. What does this negative sign denote? That body is retarding. The velocity of the body is decreasing. It is coming to rest after some time. In 0.03 seconds, it is coming to rest. Initially 25 seconds, our hand starts to apply the force now. And hand started to apply the force. And in 0.3 seconds, it came to rest. Okay. So here negative sign denotes that it is body is retarding. That is, the velocity is decreasing. So how much is the force the ball is applying? Force equal to ma. This is the force the ball is applying. How much is the force? Negative sign denotes velocity is decreasing. So 0.15 into 2500 upon 3 will be. This will be the force. This will be the force. This is the magnitude of the force. And what is the direction? This direction. This is the direction of the force applied by the ball. This is the direction applied by the force applied by the ball. So how much force you are getting this much?
125 newton.
This is the force applied by the ball on hand. Okay. Now what is the question asking? Calculate the force on here. Find the average force applied by the player. This is the force applied by ball on hand. This is the amount of force applied by ball on hand. Okay, so direction this one. This is the action force. What is the reaction force we are applying? We have to apply. So force applied by player will be how much? Minus 125. Direction will be opposite. This negative sign denotes that we are applying in opposite direction. This was the action force. This was the reaction force. Okay.
Yes, sir.
To stop the ball, we have to apply. So if ball is having how much force it is going to apply? 125 newton. That means to stop the ball, we have to apply 125 newton in opposite direction. So force applied by the player will be minus 125 newton. This is clear?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now 15th one. Okay, rest we have discussed car moving it now. Okay, 13th question. 13th question first. Car of mass 480 kg moving at a speed of 54 km per hour stopped by applying a brakes in 10 seconds. Okay, what acceleration you got?
Minus 15 upon 10.
Okay, so minus 1.5 meter per second square, meter seconds. Okay, this or this one. This is the acceleration you got. So this here negative sign denotes what? It denotes velocity is decreasing. That is, it is coming to rest.
Velocity is decreasing.
Okay. Now calculate the force applied. Where is that? Calculate the force applied by the brake. We have to calculate how much is the force applied by the brake. So F equal to ma will do. That is the force applied by the brakes. Okay. Force applied by the brake. Here, direction. So here we have to calculate only the force applied by the brake. Direction, how we can assume? Either you can say it like this. This car is moving. Some force is opposing this. This will be there. But while we are applying the brake, it means how much force we applied through brakes. That will be 1.5 meter per second square into mass. Mass is how much? 480 kg. So it will be 720 newton. It will be 720 newton. On brakes, we are applying through brakes, we are applying this much force, 720 newton. Okay, is this clear?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, if the question had been like this, okay, if the question had been like this, this is the car and someone is stopping it. So how much force this person has to apply?
Minus 720.
Because it is going to apply 720 newton and this person has to apply in opposite direction. So that will be, if the question asks only the magnitude you have to tell, then 720 newton. Okay. And here with brakes, the issue came. That is, what should we do? So I'm searching over it as well. But haven't got the correct answer that how we can interpret that one. Through brakes, which direction we will take? So usually through brakes, we are saying that we are applying 720 newton. Is this clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay, similarly in 15th question.
Sir, how the negative sign comes to positive, sir, that I not understood.
Okay, see here in braking system, so how much is the force we require to stop that body? This negative sign in acceleration denotes only the retardation, that is, body is slowing down. Direction we cannot get from acceleration. Okay, if we want to know the direction of acceleration, how we get the direction of acceleration? Through the direction which change is taking place. Through this, we cannot get the direction. Direction we are going to get from here. in which direction the velocity is changing, in which direction change in velocity is taking place, or we can say in which direction the body is moving, that direction. So in which direction the change is taking place in velocity, that will give the direction of acceleration. Okay, so to get the direction of force, we have to know the direction in which the body is moving, or in which direction the change in the velocity of the body is taking place. Okay, so here negative sign in acceleration, it only tells us that velocity is increasing or decreasing, whether the body is accelerating or decelerating. That's all. So force equal to ma, we have calculated the car, it is how much force is required to brakes, 720 newton. Okay, is this clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay,
yes, sir.
15th question regarding brakes, I will tell you afterwards as well, as I get more information over this. Okay, how big? A bullet of mass 50 gram moving with an initial velocity of 100 meter per second. Okay, this question we have done or not? A little bit we have done or not this question?
Sir, you gave homework.
Sir, you gave homework.
Okay, let's do then. So what all parameters are given? Write them down. A bullet of mass 50 gram. Mass is how much? 50 gram. In kgs, it will be how much? 0.05 kg, or this much? Okay, 0.05 kg is fine. Moving with initial velocity is 100 meter per second, and it comes to strikes a wooden block, comes to rest after penetrating a distance of 2 centimeter, that is 0.02 meter. Okay, it comes to rest, it means final velocity is zero. Okay, time is not given. We have to calculate initial momentum of a bullet. That you can easily calculate, initial momentum.
M into U.
Okay, 5 kg meter per second. Okay, that you will get. Final momentum of the bullet.
M into V.
Okay. Now, retardation caused by the wooden block. That we have to calculate. Okay, see here what is happening in this question. This is the wooden block. A bullet is there. Initially, it is moving with a velocity of 100 meter per second. It strikes here. As the wooden block strikes, what will happen? It will slow down. The velocity will start reducing. Velocity will start decreasing from 100, and it covers how much distance? 2 centimeters. Okay? It covers 2 centimeter distance. It means as it strikes the bullet, as the bullet strikes the wooden block, what happens? There is some force, there is some resistance to the motion of the bullet, there's some force applied on the bullet. So during this duration, force is being applied. And here the bullet comes to rest. So first we have to calculate the acceleration here. How you can calculate acceleration? Which formula you're going to
use? Third equation, V square equals to U square minus 2s.
Plus 2as. V square equal to U square plus 2a. V square is 0. 100 square plus 2 into a into 0.02. Calculate and tell. A equal to minus something, it will be there.
A is equals to minus 2.5 into 10 to the power 5 meter per second.
10 is to the power 5 meter per second square. So this is the acceleration. This negative sign tells that it is reducing. It is
velocity is retarding.
Well, it is retarding. The body is retarding. Okay. So now we have to calculate how much is the force applied, exerted by the wooden block. How much is the force, resistive force exerted by the wooden block?
It is equal to the force exerted by bullet.
Equal to the force exerted by the bullet. Okay. So will 2.5 into 10 raised to power 5 into 0.05. This will give us 0.2500 newton. Okay. So resistive force in my, as I see, it should be, we should have minus sign, because resistive force direction will be this direction. Yes or no? Bullet will apply force in this direction, resistive force in this direction. So it should have minus sign, I guess. Resistive force exerted by the wooden block. Or maybe in resistive force, they have taken the minus sign. So resistive force, if we take the direction, it will be opposite to the direction of motion of the, opposite to the direction of force applied by the bullet. So it should have minus sign, I think. So 13th question, braking system, as I get more information, we'll take that question. Okay. 15th question, fourth part, I think it should have minus sign. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
So, sir, but if we consider, sir, but if we consider the force exerted by the wooden block on the bullet to be positive, then it would be positive only.
Okay. If we consider that one, see here, if we are considering the force applied by this one, if we are taking plus and minus sign, they will denote us, denote the direction only. Okay. If the force applied by the bullet, if we are taking this much, this is the force applied by the bullet. Then the force applied by the wooden block will be minus sign we have. If you take the direction into consideration, if you do not take the direction, this is the resistive force applied by the wooden block, we can say. Or see here, resistive force exerted by the wooden block. Maybe only the magnitude we have to tell. Because direction we are taking care in, resistive force exerted by the bullet. How much is the resistive force exerted by the bullet? So, only the magnitude it may be asking. So this much, 12500 newton. Have you understood this one?
Yes.
So still little confusion is there. We'll
see
that. Okay, we'll see that. Okay, any, okay, 2 minutes are there, we can discuss the remaining. Page number 73. Hopping page number 1 minute is fine. We can conquer the whole world. Okay. Page number 73. Numericals. A boy pushes a wall with a force of 10 newton towards east. Okay. See how here direction we have taken. Pushes the wall 10 newton towards east. The wall will push. What with force? 10 newton towards west.
Opposite direction.
Opposite direction.
Yes.
Second one. A block of weight 50 newton is hanging from a rigid support by a string. So we are having a block hanging by a string, rigid support, and it is 15 newton. Its weight is 15 newton. Okay. What is the force exerted by the block on the string? What is the force exerted by the block on the string?
15 newton downwards.
This will be the 15 newton exerting. This is the force 15 newton exerted by the block on the string. Downward direction. Okay. String on the block. How much the force the string is applying?
15 newton.
15 newton but in upward direction. In upward direction. See here, the string applies 15 newton force upward. The block applies 15 newton downwards. So the block remains at rest position. If you cut the string, what will happen? It will go down. No more upward force applied by the string. The block will move downward. Okay. And more what you are going to see as we cut. There's a force in string upward. So you will see the string goes up and then comes downward due to gravity. That slack it is going to be half. Upwards.
It's a time over.
It's okay. There is time and time we have. As we cut, this thing moves up, then comes down because of gravity. This is clear? So name and them and show. Okay, which force it will be there in the string? That will be the tension force. Tension. That force is called as tension. Tension in the string. Okay? Now the time is over. Thank you.
Sir?
Yes? You may ask the doubts if you have.
Sir, when the exams will begin?
Exams?
Yes, sir, when the exams will
maybe,
begin?
Maybe last week of August or September 1st week. Maybe.
Sir, which chapters will come? Sir, which chapters will come in physics? In physics,
I don't know. Prepare all till now. Till now, what we have completed.
How it will occur? Whether viva or subjective, objective?
No, no idea. So prepare.
Notebook. Check.
Notebook. See, a numericals. I am taking each numerical in class, so there is no need of getting checked. So if you have doubt in numericals, do let me know anywhere if you have doubt. So we will be covering every numerical in class, okay? Or if possible, I will upload the solution as well. But really, I want to. Solution I have, all the numericals, but I don't want to upload it, or else student won't do. Yes?
Sir, we have already done, so you don't want to upload.
Many haven't done, so I don't want to upload the solution. We'll be doing each numerical in class. Here in board, we'll be doing every numerical. If you have any doubt, you may ask in class, any numerical. Every numerical will be solving in class. So if you face doubt anywhere, you may ask. As school reopens, so prepare that such that your school is
Sir, gone. When the school will reopen? Sir, when the school will open?
No idea. It depends on mainly on government, and mainly depends on people. So seeing the condition at present, without vaccination, school won't open, and that's right as well. Okay, so if you have any doubt, you may ask.